Slice of Life, episode 6. Welcome back to the Brooklyn Cyclones Good News Show, where Billy and I will try to do our best to put some smiles on your faces in quarantine. Billy looking fresh after a weekend haircut from his son. I am now with the three little pigs in my brick house, and we're ready to bring you favorite social slice.
Yeah, desperate times call for desperate measures. Needed a haircut. Gave the clippers to my 5-year-old. Worked out all right. Only a couple of bald spots. It made it work. So my favorite thing, I'll continue my theme. April's a big birthday month in the Harner family. Hint, hint. My birthday's coming up. Hint, hint. Keith's birthday's coming up. Just in case anybody out there wants to get us something. So Brandon Smith in Texas usually celebrates his birthday with a father-son excursion. They go to a golf range. They go to an amusement park. But obviously, all that's put on hold when we're practicing social distancing. So for his 12th birthday, his mom sent out a simple tweet saying that her son loved geography and was turning 12. Could you retweet and respond with where your location was so that he could mark it off on his map? Simple request. Well, the tweet went viral. And on Saturday afternoon, as I was scrolling through Twitter, Brandon was trending, which inquisitive minds wanted to know why. So I started following along and looked it up a little bit. Thousands of people from all around the globe responded to this simple tweet for this 12-year-old's birthday. My personal favorite was scientists in Antarctica conducting research experiments sent him a video from the South Pole checking in for his birthday. So that was a pretty cool thing I saw for sure. And a birthday that I'm sure he'll never forget.
Yeah, I was a huge geography nerd when I was a kid. I knew all 50 capitals and 50 states and countries around the world. And immersive learning, man. That's the way it is. So I never had anybody tweet for me from Antarctica, but that's pretty unbelievable that there's life down there.
Yeah, it was cool. All the people that got involved, you know, the Prime Minister, I think, of Scotland tweeted at him, the Toronto Blue Jays. So, you know, just among a bunch of different people. He had a little map that he marked off. It was pretty cool to see.
For my favorite social slice, club quarantine. This is a classic. I'm a little closer to my 21st birthday than you are, Bill. It's just a couple of years back. But check out this video from the sister, Emily Torchia, for her brother's 21st.
Smitty, please.
Hi. Welcome to Club Quarantine. We'll bring you the 21st birthday. It's our policy that we give you a free green tea shot. And we let the bouncer, the waitress.
So, Bill, they got everybody involved. Dad's the bouncer outside. Mom is doing the bartending. And there's one thing in that video that I love, and I know you got a kick out of, was the leg lamp from Christmas Story on the bar. That was like the first thing that popped out.
For sure. I mean, it was great. Dad outside with the flashlight. You know, we've all been there. We've had our 21st birthday. It's a coming of age thing. And then you go inside and mom's doing shots of green tea with Sprite, which sounds absolutely repulsive, but it's the thought that counts, I guess. So it was pretty fun and a great way to spend, you know, sort of raising the bar for all parents out there of what you're going to do to sort of entertain your kids in this situation.
Yeah, I gotta let my parents know to at least build a backyard garage club. That is killer. Time for some chicken parm heroes. My heroes for today are Brooklyn based from Sunset Park, the Matza Project. Ashley Albert, Kevin Rodriguez, the two behind the project. You might know Ashley a little bit more. She is the owner operator, and she refers to herself as the big cheese behind the Royal Palms Shuffleboard Club, one of the coolest places in Brooklyn to hang out in. But side project is this Matza Project. They delivered chips all over the place to 6 Mount Sinai hospitals. So good to see. Small startup, but doing some big things. Everybody loves free food, Bill, no matter how big or small it is.
The great equalizer is always free food and free t-shirts. No matter how much money you have in your pocket, no matter how much money you have in your bank account, everybody loves a free t-shirt, including Keith Rad with his Jake Mangum t-shirt.
Shout out to the free t-shirt club who sent it in. Billy, yours was another cool thing. We're kind of on this bar theme, I guess, today, but what was yours?
Yeah, I think we all need a drink at this point of the quarantine, so we know what's on our minds. So Jennifer Knox is the owner of The Sand Bar in Georgia. It's a popular tourist spot on Tybee Island. I looked up the pronunciation so I'd get it right. It's just off of Savannah. So it's a popular summer destination, popular vacation spot. And they have a unique tradition where when you go there, you can take a dollar bill, sign your name on it, staple it to the wall, wish good luck, leave a message, sort of like a guest book. And now that the bar was closed and the staff was not going to be getting their income as they normally would at this time of the year, Jennifer came up with an idea where they were going to take all the money off the wall and use it for the workers there. So over the course of 3 days, Jennifer and her employees and some volunteers went through and took off all the money from the wall, totaling over $4,000 that she then gave directly to her employees as some cash for them to use to get through the lockdown there in Tybee Island. So I thought it was a pretty cool idea. You know, we've all been at bars like that before where there's, you know, a unique thing that they do on the walls. And this was, I thought, something cool for her to give back to their employees as well.
Yeah, it reminded me of one of the great lines of all time. Never forget, there's always money in the banana stand. Sports. We didn't know who was going to crack first in baseball. There's been many plans going around. When does the season start? How's it going to happen? And one of the more recent plans is the, I guess you call it the Arizona Project, where all the players would go to Arizona, stay in a hotel, wouldn't see their families. And here's Paul Hamels, who just jumps out from the Atlanta Braves. He told The Score, yeah, I wouldn't mind, you know, leaving my family, going to play baseball, making that sacrifice. Somebody had to say it first. A couple of things, though. He's 36. His time is limited. I get it. And there's something that I learned about Cole Hamels living in Frisco, Texas, when I worked for the Frisco Rough Riders, that showed me that Cole Hamels loves his family more than baseball, for everyone out there who's concerned. Cole rehabbed with the Rough Riders when he was pitching for the Rangers, pitched 5 innings, showered, did the whole training stuff, got iced up, and then went out to the Lazy River in right field with his family for the rest of the game. The game's going on that he pitched in. He's in the pool, Bill. But Hamels is the first guy to, I guess, get his name on the record.
Yeah, very, very cool to see, you know, guys like that in their natural element with their families. You know, when we've had rehab guys, you see them with their wives, their kids, and they enjoy what they're doing. So it's cool to see them like that. And I also feel Cole Hamels' pain. You know, my kids aren't listening. All right, good, yeah. I wouldn't mind a little self-quarantine in Arizona to play baseball with my buddies for a little while either, so I get it. On my side of sports, I'm going to just go back. Every Sunday night, John Krasinski puts out his SGN show that we've admitted was sort of the impetus for us doing this, and he's doing it much better and on a much larger scale than we are. So last night, John Krasinski, who is a Boston Red Sox fan, had David Ortiz come on and had several members of the COVID-19 unit working at Beth Israel Deaconess Hospital up in Massachusetts come on and gave them a special surprise. David Ortiz gave 4 season tickets to the unit. He had the duck boats ready to give them their own Boston-style championship parade, which took them straight to Fenway, where they had the ballpark to themselves. John referenced how should have been Major League Baseball opening day and we're all missing sports. So he had them throw the unofficial first pitch of the season from the mound.
I need you to do it for your country. I need you to do it for baseball fans everywhere. Can you do that? All right, here we go. Throwing out the first pitch of the 2020 Major League Baseball season. The staff of Beth Israel Deaconess COVID unit. Here we go.
And to cap it all off, which I thought was absolutely sensational, AT&T partnered with John and is now giving 3 free months of wireless service to all healthcare workers because of obviously their efforts here and on the heroic efforts in the COVID-19 pandemic that we're dealing with. So very cool for John Krasinski to keep doing what he's doing. Very cool for the Red Sox to get involved just, you know, in all this stuff, why we're doing this, to see the good in people and see the happiness come out of it. One thing that I wanted to bring out was one of the doctors from Beth Israel Deaconess, when he was talking to John, said that he wanted to know why people are dwelling on the negative and not talking about all the people that are getting recovered and get going home and getting to go back with their families, because that's why these people are working as hard as they are. So that's a great sentiment from the doctor. And a question that we all should sort of be asking is, you know, there's a lot of bad stuff going on, and there are people getting better, and there are people out there that are recovering. So they're working for a reason, and they're doing a great job of it. So appreciate those doctors that and nurses that were mentioned last night, and doctors everywhere. They're continuing to do a great job. Thanks, John Krasinski, for this idea, and keep doing such a great thing. And as a Yankee fan yourself, I know it's tough to give props to the Red Sox, but they did a great thing as well.
Yeah, it was awesome. We have 100% stolen this show idea from John Krasinski, but positive news, though. It's a positive influence on our lives and hopefully Cyclones fans. By the way, final thing before we go, Bill, does your son do house calls? Because I am just dying over here with this fro.
Yeah, I mean, we can work on that. There's going to be, he'll have to get some type of pole apparatus to keep the social distancing. But you can see that right there, one nice little bald spot. But other than that, not too bad. For a five-year-old, what do you expect? I cut down his tip a little bit when it was over because of the bald spot, but what do you think?
Billy, we'll see you tomorrow. My name is Keith. This has been Slice of Life, episode 6. Have a good day.
Take care, everybody.